You here for your bike?
Hey, what's up?
Get back to work.
Didn't do anything. Oh, shit!
Hey, hold on.
Oh, how's it going?
Last time I saw Boozer was a few weeks ago.
He's still around. Yeah, same as ever. Guess he's just been busy.
Heard a rumor that he got hurt or something.
That's just Tucker making shit up. He's fine.
Whatever. Mm-hmm. Right. Later, man.
That's all I got for now.
You think wood smoke will give you cancer? I can't even breathe.
Thank you.
So, you want to learn how to hunt? Is that what I'm hearing?
I know how to shoot a gun.
It's a rifle, not a gun.
I was in the 10th Mountain Cope. Don't give me any Marine Corps bullshit.
Killing a buck's a little different than killing a man. Or a freak. The best way to hunt an animal is to track it. You gotta focus. And see what nature's trying to tell you. If you look hard enough, you'll see the signs.
Well, okay then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh.
Yeah, I see it.
They lead this way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on then. Quick, there's your buck.
I see him.
Now here, use my rifle. If you were in the 10th Mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this.
Got him. Nice shot.
Oh, goddammit, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
No, no, that's okay. You wounded him. He'll bleed out soon enough. We just gotta track him.
Okay.
See the blood spots? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
And follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay, you know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look, Cope, Boozer and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say, no disrespect to Boozer, but you got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
Cope says you've been helping out around the camp. He won't say it, but he appreciates it.
Hey, Manny.
Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. Good choice, man. Good choice. This should last you for a while. You don't want to run out of fuel in the shit, that's for sure. Wrap that up for you. Cool. Need anything else? Oh yeah, that's a good piece. Look me up if you need anything else. See ya.
How's it going, booze man?
Fine, goddammit. Hey, Dean, we're getting low on supplies. Could use some more meat if you get a chance.
Oh, shit. Okay. I guess it's been a while since we did any hunt. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out. Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers. Believe it or not.
Oh, shit. I don't believe it. Thanks, dude.
See you, old man.
Products cheap foreign labor could churn out. Everything in the last 50 years.
Beach. How about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not a doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry, Lieutenant O'Brien. How long are we going to be here?
That takes, Corbin. As it takes. I thought I saw something in our approach. I'm going to check it out.
Yeah?
It's probably nothing. Fresh carrion, maybe.
Who's there?
Okay, Doc. Lieutenant, don't become carrion yourself.
Only animals can become carrion, Corporal, not humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
This way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself, and I would have that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero, Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, that if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive, O'Brien?
What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night,
Nero Protocol 2-7 states
that everyone was dead. They were slaughtered, torn limb from goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little spacesuit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember at the rooftop of the old brewery, I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but... I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't... Hey, you don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got out of the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Man, a few days ago, I asked you if you were on your own ass.
Okay, get some shut-eye boost, man. I'm telling you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as the arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke.
There, O'Brien. You son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? You're on this channel. God damn it. You better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it. Oh, come on, O'Brien. Get back to me.
It was him.
And did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't think she's still alive?
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died. I don't need to find any peace, Jesus. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. I grew up in these here woods. My grandfather taught me all about hunting. Funny how it still works in a world he never would have dreamed of. I built my first treehouse to use as a deer blind. Getting height on your target helps your aim and keeps you safe. Back then, I took out my first doe from up top. Today, my camp's up in the trees. You want to survive and can contribute. come to me. We got you covered. Grandfather also taught me to catch a doe. Sometimes you gotta lay an ambush. Hide where they need to go. Like a watering hole. Today, you're as likely to be prey as Hunter. So you gotta keep your eyes peeled when you're hitting up places we all need to go. But Grandfather always said the easiest way to a good meal was to lay a trap. Put a snare by a tree, and you could have dinner next time you come round. But careful. A headless snake can still bite. Especially when it ain't really dead.
Here it is.
Okay, now my grandfather would have outlived us all. Let me tell you. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Well, that's great, Cope. So you and your granddaddy set traps for him, and you and your old man used to lay down salt licks. Yeah, that's real sporting. I guess none of that shit matters now.
Yeah!
trapped. Please. I gotta help.
God, help me. I'm trapped. Help me.
Get you out of there.
You're not gonna make it out here. I know where there's a camp.
No, no, where? Where? I'll go. Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. Safe there.
Oh my God. Thank you so much. I thought I was gonna die in there.
Yeah, let him know it was Deacon St. John.
I just keep running. Stay off the road.
see.
It should do it.
another bounty. Something under this.
Yeah. Hey, booze man, I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke, thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.
Just gotta close my eyes for a bit. I'm ready to go back at it.